Welcome to my final look for the Dutch NYX Face Awards. The theme of this challenge is lucid dreams, so I came up with this look that shows you the feeling that I get whenever I realize I'm having a lucid dream. Because in this moment you realize that you can literally do and be everything you've ever dreamt of. And honestly, that's an amazing feeling. If you want me to win the Dutch NYX Face Awards, then please vote for me. I will leave all the information of where to vote and how to vote in the description box down below. So let's just jump right into the tutorial. First onto the headpiece. I'm taking different size skewers and a plastic hairband. I'm just going to see how I'm going to place these skewers, just so I get kind of an idea of what I want to do. And then I'm taking a piece of cardboard and I'm going to trace the headband on the cardboard and I'm going to cut that out. And I'm going to glue this on top of the headband. And later on we're going to glue the skewers on top of this piece of cardboard, because if you would just glue it on top of the headband alone, they would not stand up. And that's kind of the point of a headpiece. So then I'm taking the skewers and I'm going to glue these onto the cardboard with a hot glue gun. And for this layer I'm only going to use the large skewers that I have. And when we have something like this, I'm going to place another layer of cardboard on top of the skewers. And on top of this piece of cardboard, I'm going to glue the smaller pieces of skewer. And I'm doing this because it kind of creates more depth into the headpiece and it just makes it a little bit more interesting. So when this is done, I spray painted it white and then I'm taking a glue spray and some beautiful iridescent glitter. And I'm just going to glue these glitters on top of the headpiece because honestly, it just makes it look a lot more beautiful. Then I'm taking this beautiful piece of holographic paper, and this is actually a pom-pom that you hang on the ceiling, but I realized that if you open it you kind of get like a beautiful strip of holographic paper, and because it has different layers it kind of looks like clouds as well, so it's perfect for this headpiece. And again, I'm using a hot glue gun for this, and be sure to be very careful when using a hot glue gun because it actually is pretty damn hot and I've burnt myself so many times while making this headpiece, so be careful. To hide that ugly piece of cardboard you're seeing right now, I'm taking a fluffy pipe cleaner and I cut it to the right size, and I'm using my hot glue gun just to glue it on top of the headpiece. And this is basically everything you have to do. So yeah, let's go on to the makeup. So Naked Lindy is back, and this time my brows just magically disappeared. I'm also wearing some blue contacts and I slicked my hair back with some gel because we're gonna apply a bald cap. And this is actually the first time I've ever used a bald cap, so as you can see it's not looking very professional. But what you wanna do is of course place the bald cap on your head, and then I'm just going to cut out where my ears are because they have to be visible for this look. And then with a skin safe adhesive, I'm just going to glue the edges of the bald cap down. And this is actually a water-based skin adhesive, so you can remove it with some water. So what you want to do is take a makeup wipe and remove the excess glue on your head. But I didn't really have makeup wipes anymore, so I used a wet piece of fabric to remove the glue. And with a wet piece of fabric, I mean I used my sock. Okay, beauty vlogger of the year right here, I know. To hide the edges of the bald cap, you just want to take some liquid latex and a disposable sponge. And I'm placing the liquid latex on the edges, of course, and I'm also placing it on top of the bald cap as well. When the liquid latex is totally dry, you just want to set everything in place with some setting powder. onto the foundation. I'm taking the NYX Total Control Drop Foundation in the lightest shade. And I'm using the lightest shade because we're gonna use with pastel colors. So you want the base to be as light as possible, because otherwise the colors aren't really gonna show up. And that's kind of what we want in this look. Taking a white foundation, and I'm just going to highlight the high points of my face and of my chest as well, just to create a little definition. And then I'm going to set this all again with some NYX SFX setting powder. For the purple contour, I'm taking the NYX Ultimate Brights Palette, and I'm taking the lilac-y color, and I'm just going to use this to contour my face, and I'm also going to apply it on the center of my head as well. And for this part I used a smaller brush, just so I could get a little bit more pigment on my face. And I'm also going to use this to contour my chest as well. Then I'm taking this blue color from the Ultimate Brights palette, and I'm going to apply this on the other parts of my face. And for some reason my camera stopped recording while I was doing this, so I basically just applied the blue onto my temples, under the purple contour that I have on my cheeks, and on my neck and on my shoulders as well. And then I'm just going in with that lilac again, just to intensify the color. To bring a little more color into the look, I'm taking this hot pink eyeshadow, and I'm just going to place this on top of the lilac that we already applied. So this is going to give the look a little bit more definition, but also a little bit more depth in the contour. So then I was just looking at myself, and I kind of realized that I was looking like a burnt chicken nugget. So I thought it might be better to just continue on the eyes, because that is really going to bring this entire look together. I'm taking that lilac-y color again, and I'm starting by applying it on the inner corner, and I'm winging it out all into my temple. And I'm also taking it a little bit on the bridge of my nose as well. Then I'm taking that hot pink eyeshadow again, and I'm just going to match the color of my eyes to the color on my cheek and on my chest as well. So I'm just placing this on top of the lilac. And then with the white eyeshadow base, I'm going to cut the inner corner of my crease. And I'm blending this out with a clean brush, and then I'm taking some white eyeshadow to set this all in place. And then I'm taking this white liquid liner, and I'm going to make a graphic eyeliner. So I'm starting by the inner corner of my eyes, and I'm just going to follow the line of my cut crease. But then I'm just going to take it all up in my temple as well. So I'm following the line of my eyeshadow. And then you have something like this. With the Epic Ink Liner, I'm just quickly going to line my lash line, and I'm doing this to hide the bend of the fake lashes that we're going to apply later on. Then I'm taking some beautiful small iridescent glitters, but I also use some big chunkier iridescent glitters, and I'm going to place this on the white that we made earlier. And then onto lashes, I'm taking the Doll Eye Mascara, and I'm just going to apply that to my lashes, of course. And I'm also going to apply these beautiful big lashes, which basically are like a bunch of lashes stacked up on each other. And then the eyes are done, so we can continue on the rest again. So with the blue eyeshadow, I'm just going to intensify the blue that I already had on my body, because I wanted it to be a little bit more opaque. And I also took some of that lilac-y color and applied it to my lower arm and my lower chest as well. But you can't really see it, but you know, I'm definitely applying some eyeshadow over there. Then onto the lips, I'm taking the lilac eyeshadow, and I'm going to apply this on the edges of my mouth, on my cupid's bow, and on the tip of my nose. And this is all going to make it look very smoky and dreamy. And then I'm taking the NYX Liquid Suede in Sway, and I'm just going to apply this on my lips as well. And then with that hot pink eyeshadow that we used earlier, I'm just going to match the color of my lips a little bit to my chest and to my contour as well. And then it's time for highlight! I'm taking this beautiful holographic highlight, and I'm placing this on the high points of my body. And I also applied it on my forehead, but we're going to cover that part later on, so you really don't have to do that because it's kinda useless. I got a bunch of triangles out of that holographic paper that I used for the headpiece as well. And I'm just going to glue this onto my forehead using that same skin adhesive. And I applied them in layers, and I did this to make sure that there wasn't going to peek any skin through anymore. So it was only going to be a holographic forehead. And because this is kind of our centerpiece of the makeup, I'm just taking this white liquid liner again, and I'm going to outline the triangle, because this is really gonna make it stand out even more. And then I took this nail dotting tool, which actually fits the aesthetic of this look perfectly. And I drew some random dots onto the blue parts, just to make it look a little bit more interesting. I glued the holographic triangles to my neck as well, because this is going to make the chest look a little bit more interesting. And it's also going to kind of connect the face look with the chest look. And of course, I'm also applying those white dots on the blue parts of my shoulders as well. I kind of felt like the under eyes were a little bit too boring, so I took some of the blue eyeshadow and I just smudged this underneath my eyes as well. Then I took this baby powder eye pencil and I couldn't open the packaging because I'm really weak. And once I opened it, I actually broke the pencil. But I'm using this pencil to line my waterline. And then I'm taking this holographic rhinestone and I'm just going to glue this underneath my lash line. Taking that white liquid eyeliner again, I'm just going to make that same outline on the holographic part of my neck as well. And I'm also using this eyeliner to kind of create some highlights on my face. So I applied it on my lips, on my nose, on my cheeks and on my collarbone. And this is going to make the makeup look glossy, even though it's not glossy, if you know what I mean. And with some chunky glitters, I'm just going to create a little bit more highlight on my cheeks, on my nose and on my collarbones. And then I'm taking this holographic bead and I'm going to glue it on top of my lip. And this is kind of going to make it look like I've got a Medusa piercing, which I absolutely love. And then I'm taking one of these round holographic thingies and I'm going to glue that on my chest, which for some reason I found really difficult to do. And then I took this beautiful blue wig, I took my headpiece, and I also made this bra to match the look, but you didn't really end up seeing it in the video. But you know, I tried and that's all that matters. So yeah guys, this is my final look for the Dutch NYX Face Awards. I really hope you guys liked it. If you did, please don't forget to vote for me. Again, I will leave all the information of where to vote and how to vote in the description box down below. And yeah, let's hope we're gonna win, because that would be amazing. Thank you guys for watching and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye!